Hey guys, it's Suja. I'm back in a very, very long time with another cooking lesson. And I wanted to post for a very long time because this is a dish that I really, really enjoy. But you know, with like, because I'm a rising senior with all like the internships, volunteering, and camps going on, I really couldn't make a lot of time for this. But I really want to introduce you guys to this dish because it's one of my favorites. It's called 즈비면, and 즈 stands for this base that we're going to be using, and 비 is short for 비빔, which means to mix in Korean, and then 면 stands for noodle. Formally, it's called 즈비면, but informally, it's called 마약국수, and literally, it translates to like drug noodles, but that's nothing like what it is. It's called drug noodles because they taste so good that like you get addicted to it and you keep eating it as if they were a drug. So don't think it's anything bad for you. It's actually really, really healthy for you, and it actually got popular because it's good and it's good for people who diet. So it's like killing two birds with one stone. The thing about this dish that makes it really good is that you're mixing the perfect amount of sweet with the perfect amount of salty, which makes you eat like a lot. You know how like when you eat your hot Cheetos, you gotta get that ice cream, and then you gotta get that like chicken, and then you gotta get like your cola? It's kind of like that. So when you get a perfect balance of sweet and salty, you keep eating it, which is also why it's called drug noodles. And the part why it's so healthy is because of the main ingredients, these noodles. These are yam noodles, and they sound disgusting and they kind of look disgusting, but they actually taste really good. And it's so chewy. It's like jelly noodles, but it has zero calories, like zero, zero, like zero, like yum, like no calories at all, which is why this is the perfect ingredient for a diet food. Now onto the ingredients. The main ingredients of this dish, as I mentioned before, are these yam noodles, and then this mensuyu. I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce it because it's Japanese, but this actually, if you look at it, it's normally made for like soba. So when you eat cold soba, this is the sauce that you would put in, but it also goes in here. And then cucumber and green onions. These are mandatory, necessary, so eat your veggies. And then these two tiny bell peppers, they're not necessary, but I would highly suggest them because they add a little flavor and color and fun to the dish. And last but not least, seaweed. This is roasted and salted, so this is part of where the salty part comes out, and it tastes really good if you mix it in with these noodles. Now time to cut the ingredients.
Bell peppers into thin slices.
Cut the green onions into thirds and then dice them. Next, we're gonna drain the yam noodles and then rinse them in cold water. For the sauce, we're gonna put 2 tablespoons in. I cut the seaweed into rectangles so that it's easier for me to cut it.
I love seaweed, so I'm going to cut a lot.
So you're just going to cut the seaweed in thin strips. I decided to add 1 tablespoon of sesame seeds to make it more savory. As a lover of sesame, I would want to put sesame oil in too. And I would do this right before you eat so you could get all the flavor and all of the scent. Is ready to eat. It smells really, really good and it looks healthy but like yummy at the same time, so I'm really excited to try this. This is really good. Like, I made it, but it's good. You know, I think I know why these are called drug noodles. It tastes like so good and so addicting, and I can't stop my chopsticks, so I'm just gonna eat while you guys are watching me. So I really hope you guys try this, especially you sesame lovers, because it tastes so good, it smells so good, it looks colorful and beautiful. And it's a really, really healthy snack for dinner or lunch.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give a like and subscribe.